I would like to welcome formally, I mean, we already have informally received Mr. Martin. Mr. Martin Kobler has been here twice. This is the third time he is here. We are really obliged and we really appreciate. You are the first ambassador ever who has been here for three times. And we know that you got a kind heart in your chest, and we know that you are an active person. You are someone who really care about people, who really care about happiness, and you are spreading happiness, and we really appreciate it. We will definitely miss you. We know that your mission is coming to an end in Pakistan, and I hope it was extended. I hope you were here. I hope we were able to offer you the citizenship of Pakistan and you would have been with us forever. We just consider you as another Pakistani, just like any other Pakistani. And but anyhow, just to make it short, we would love to be in touch with you. We would love to benefit from your thoughts and your ideas and your mission, and we would we would try from our side in whatever way we can to keep your memories alive at Paraplegic Center. Thank you. Thank again you. Sir, thank you.
Dear friends, this is indeed my last visit here in Peshawar, my last visit here during my tenure. But you see, there is a probability I'm coming back even if I do not have a Pakistani citizen, because now also normal tourists can go to Peshawar without an NOC. So that's why I'm coming. Now, the reason I'm continuously thinking about you and being here is really the first contact made by you and some of your colleagues. It was not my initiative. You came to me and you told us, listen, I mean, we just check your embassy. This is an inspection tour. And we want to see whether you have ramps everywhere.
Be careful.
You see, and then be careful. And then I have seen that we do not have ramps in our embassy. You could not visit me in my office because it was on the first floor. However, we managed to bring you to my residence, and we had several meetings since. And I made it a point also to invite you to our National Day to present yourself and to lobby, because advocacy and the destigmatization of the paraplegics, I think this is very important, that you must be considered a normal part of society. Yes, you have some special needs. However, I admire your way you are going out. And believe me, I'm also one of your ambassadors. Yesterday I was in Qaeda Azam University, and I went up and down and up and down, and I told them, listen, where are the ramps? If I were now a paraplegic. And they did not have ramps, and they never thought about it, because they do not have wheelchairs or other people with special needs in the university. Now, that's why I think, you see, and this is really, you have spoken about a good heart. I don't know whether I have a good heart, but I'm convinced that a society proves itself how they treat, number one, minorities, and number two, people with special needs. Now, and not only the mainstream, those who can walk, those who can read, and those who can hear, or those who are Muslims. No, it's also the minorities, the Hindus, the Christians living in your country, everybody. Only then a society can thrive. And that's why, you see, I always, in regular intervals, I was coming here to you, bring also colleagues with me, and be sure that I will continue to be linked with you, maybe not physically, but virtually. I would be very happy if our kind of communication could continue, even if I'm not here. And we discuss it later. I really want to stay and continue to support the Paraplegic Center here. I'm very fond of the friends of paraplegics. You might see that very often they tag you in my tweets whenever whenever it's useful for you, because you are really doing a great job in order to out yourself and to go out and to present yourself to the people. But my thanks also goes to the management, of course. My thanks goes to those who are standing volunteers here behind me, the volunteers, the many volunteers, the women and men who are here, the doctors and the physiotherapists and the psychologists, because this is equally important also to support you and to strengthen you in your work. Now, thank you very much. I would be happy if communication could go on. I will go on the 10th of April. I will leave the country and I will go to Ethiopia to join my wife. But as a retired man, I also there will continue then to make contacts if they don't have it with Paraplegics in Ethiopia. Maybe you can establish some Skype sessions here with your sisters and brothers in another part of the world, because I think psychological support and the solidarity, you see, I cannot really understand how your living conditions are. Only you among yourselves can do it. So maybe it's also a chance to open up internationally. I particularly always admired that your strength, and that you also do sports, and that you train, and that you really take up all these challenges, you see, to do sports. You see, I only can say I admire you. And thank you very much for this friendship. Some of you, if you are interested, just come to my farewell brunch on the 7th. Yes. It's just an informal gathering, you see. Just come there, you see. Just tell me before how many of you are coming, and then you are welcome in the garden just for an informal gathering, because the day after I will leave the country. Thank you very much for your friendship. I continue to support you, and I continue to lobby also for the needs and for what you need in society.
Few conclusive words to just see the lens of camera continuously, and you should say some few words related to the needs and rights of persons with disabilities, being an ambassador of the Friends of Paraplegics.
Well, I'm here for the third time now here in the Paraplegic Center in Peshawar, and right from the beginning, when the Friends of Paraplegic, they have initiated the contact with me, I continued to this contact, and that's why I'm very happy to be here again. I think it's very important that the Friends of Paraplegics, they continue their work on advocacy with society, to go out to society, to participate in social life.